The warriors, who had been rather confused by these incidents, now formed their ranks again, and the Sawhorse pranced across the room to Dorothy and took a position beside the hungry tiger. At that moment the doors that led to the palace flew open, and the people of Ev and the people of Oz were disclosed to view. They paused, astonished at the sight of the warriors and the angry Nome King seated in their midst.
"Surrender!" cried the king in a loud voice. "You are my prisoners!"
"Go long," answered Billina from the Scarecrow's shoulder. "You promised me that if I guessed correctly, my friends and I might depart in safety, and you always keep your promises."
"I said you might leave the palace in safety," retorted the king, "and so you may, but you cannot leave my dominions. You are my prisoners, and I will hurl you all into my underground dungeons, where the volcanic fires glow, and the molten lava flows in every direction, and the air is hotter than blue blazes."
"That will be the end of me, all right," said the Scarecrow sorrowfully. "One small blaze, blue or green, is enough to reduce me to an ash heap."
"Do you surrender?" demanded the king.
Billina whispered something in the Scarecrow's ear that made him smile and put his hands in his jacket pockets.
"No," returned Ozma, boldly answering the king.
Then she said to her army, "Forward, my brave soldiers, and fight for your ruler and yourselves unto death."
"Pardon me, most royal Ozma," replied one of her generals, "but I find that I and my brother officers all suffer from heart disease, and the slightest excitement might kill us. If we fight, we may get excited. Would it not be well for us to avoid this grave danger?"